Good morning students, I am going to release the next video that related to that of human male reproductive system. In the event of human reproduction, the first event was that production of gametes. By which process the gametes are produced from the gonads, that is called as gametogenesis. These gametes are produced from gonads. So in the case of a male, the gametes are sperms and it is produced from the male gonad, that is testis. So it is called as spermatogenesis. The production of spermatozoa from the male gonad testis, that is called as spermatogenesis. Testis is endocrine and cytogenic in nature. As endocrine gland, it secretes sex hormone, and as cytogenic, it produces the cell, that is sperms. So by which process the sperms are produced from the male gonad testis, that is called as spermatogenesis. And another one is the production of that egg or ovum called as oogenesis. The production of egg from the female gonad ovary. So first of all, we will discuss about that spermatogenesis. Testis internally lined with germinal epithelial cells. These germinal cells, epithelial cells, undergo repeated mitotic division so that it produces huge number of daughter cells. The germinal epithelial cells are diploid, that is 2m, and it undergo mitotic division so that it produces the daughter cells in the form of 2n numbers of chromosomes. So from these germinal epithelial cells, some become larger and their capability to divide rapidly, they are called as primordial germ cells. These primordial germ cells undergo repeated mitotic division so that produces in numbers of spermatogonia. This spermatogenesis is further divided into two processes. One is formation of spermatid, and another one is formation of spermatozoa. So these are the two important processes that are involved in spermatogenesis. First one is the formation of spermatid, and second one is formation of spermatozoa or transformation of that spermatid into spermatozoa. So first of all, formation of spermatid. As testis lined with germinal epithelium, among these germinal epithelium, some larger cells, cuboidal cells, having capacity to divide rapidly by the process of mitosis and produces a huge number of daughter cells, they are also diploid. So these diploid cells are called as primordial germ cells. These primordial germ cells undergo repeated mitotic division, and that process is called as multiplication phase. This formation of spermatid further divided into three phases. First one is multiplication phase. Second one is growth phase. And third one is maturation phase. So formation of a spermatid involves these three phases. First one is multiplication phase. By that multiplication phase, the spermatogonia or sperm mother cells undergo repeated mitotic division and produces a huge number of daughter cells. These spermatogonia or daughter cells, they are diploid in nature. As the process of cell division is mitosis, so the daughter individuals are similar to their parent cell and having diploid number of chromosomes in it. That is why they are 2N. Then the growth phase. Some of the spermatogonium, they grow up just it become doubled by intake of protein materials, by synthesis of protein, by synthesis of RNA, and by absorbed materials, it is just to grow up into its double. That is why spermatogonia become doubled in size to become that primary spermatocyte, and in which phase it occurs, that is called as growth phase. So in growth phase, primary spermatocyte is formed, it is just doubled to that of size of spermatogonia. So it is 2N as for that chromosome number. So primary spermatocyte is 2N, spermatogonia is also having 2N number of chromosome. Just increase in size, that is why it is called as growth phase. The third phase is maturation phase. In maturation phase, that primary spermatocyte undergo meiotic cell division. As you have already known that the process of meiosis is divided into two phases. One is the meiosis one, that is the reduction division, where the chromosome number become haploid from that diploid. And the second division or meiosis 2 is equational division, that is similar to that of mitosis. So in first meiotic division, the diploid primary spermatocyte undergo divide into two haploid secondary spermatocyte. As it is reduction division, the diploid or 2N number of chromosome of that primary spermatocyte reduced to two haploid, that is N and N. So secondary spermatocytes are produced in the next phase, that is meiosis 2. As it is an equational division, the secondary spermatocyte undergo divide mitotically to produce two daughter cells from each secondary spermatocyte. So there are two secondary spermatocytes. So at last, in this phase, in this maturation phase, four spermatids are produced. They are haploid in comparison to that of primary spermatocyte, as it contains half number of chromosome in comparison to that of primary spermatocyte. So at the end of that maturation phase, haploid four spermatids are produced. So this is all about that formation of spermatid, and spermatid is already produced. But the second phase is formation of spermatozoa. The transformation of that spermatid into active spermatozoa or sperm is called as spermiogenesis. So formation of spermatozoa is otherwise called as spermiogenesis or spermatolysis. So the process of transformation of inactive spermatid into active spermatozoa is called as spermiogenesis or spermatolysis. So during this phase, during this spermiogenesis, during this transformation of spermatid into spermatozoa, certain changes occurs in that inactive spermatid. So it get converted into active spermatozoa, motile spermatozoa, which is able to travel along the ductus of that female genital tract. So that it can reach to that of ampulla for the process of fertilization. So what are the changes that occurs during formation of that spermatozoa from the inactive spermatid? First of all, nuclear changes occurs. The nucleus loses its nuclear shell and becomes smaller and elongated, which form the anterior most part of that sperm, that is called as sperm head. Then the second event, second change is formation of acrosome, which is mostly important event in this process of spermiogenesis. Acrosome is formed from Golgi complex, but one of the vacuole of that Golgi complex get enlarged and it lies in front of that sperm nucleus, which form the head cap, and remaining masses of that Golgi complex after formation of acrosome, it is called as Golgi rest, and they also discarded from that cytoplasm. Then the third change that occurs in that spermiogenesis, that is mitochondrial changes. The vesicular mitochondria that present within the spermatid, they become spirally coiled around that axial filament of sperm, and that type of formation of that spirally coiled mitochondria called Neven curve. That process called Neven curve. So by this process, the vesicular mitochondria get converted into spirally coiled mitochondria, that spirally coil around the axial filament. Then formation of a centriole. The centriole of that sperm, there are four numbers of centriole. The first one that lies along the depression of that nucleus, that is called as proximal centriole. This proximal centriole introduced into the secondary oocyte during fertilization for completion of that second meiotic division or to become that secondary oocyte into a matured ovum. The second centriole, that is called as a distal centriole. That distal centriole lies perpendicular to that of a proximal centriole in the neck region of that sperm, and it forms the basal granules of axial filament. And that axial filament, around it, the mitochondria wind up. Then the third one is two numbers of ring centriole are formed, which have the unknown function, but it lies at the end of middle piece. So these are the changes that occurs during conversion of that inactive spermatid into active spermatozoa. So this is all about that process of spermatogenesis, the part of that gametogenesis. It is the male gametogenesis. And later on, I will discuss about the structure of sperm in my next video. Thank you.